Here's the setup on the mill. 41 dividing head turned at 45 degrees. That's the bevel or the chamfer on the face of the dial. So we have a flat surface. I have four jaws chuck on here. I have a 5C collet holder, square one, and that's holding the work with a collet. We'll be using the 20 hole circle on the circle plate, and we're using up here, we'll zoom in a little bit. You can see here's the work. We're using my diamond engrave, which is spring loaded on the end there, out of my X carve. I just have it mounted in a collet, and we have the quill locked in place. Even if it turns, it wouldn't matter, but it won't turn. We're just going to scratch across there. I brought it up approximately 10 thousandths, as far as the compression goes, and it should slip right across there, and we're ready to go. So the first line will be a full line, and it will go the whole way. The rest of the lines, then we'll have four short lines halfway, and then a full line. And we're just going to use the DRO to tell when we're about halfway. First, we're going to do the first line right there. And then we'll turn. I want to do it this way so that you'll be able to see the marks as we go. I have to go one revolution and then 12 holes. And that looks pretty good. Then we're just going to eyeball that halfway, mark that as zero.
Done.
Came out nice. There we go. Look at that. Those came out just awesome. Let's put it together. All right, well, that's got to go in there, and then it's got to slip in. Then you got to get it engaged. Now, we'll screw that down tight, or down, I mean, it should say until it's all flush, and get a good look at it. There we go. Anyway, that came out just awesome. We'll put a little mark on there on the slide. Maybe a little center punch mark. Maybe an engrave mark. Anyway, I really like that. Now we just need to make some cutting tools. We can give her a try.